Last one, you have a short question for me?
Yeah, kind of the nature of the question is, does your view kind of reduce to a determinism? And the way I worded the question, and this is not to be snarky, but says, if the natural universe is all there is, why do atheists and agnostics want to convince me of that? Because isn't just what I think just a outgrowth of the neurons that are firing in my brain? And if it's just kind of physical process, why would they be concerned about what I think one way or the other?
Okay, so I think there's one logical problem you have there is you're saying because it's a physical process, therefore it's all determined. I guess those don't really equate. I think that, for example, when I was an electron, I have an electronics degree and we learned about op amps. And op amps, you have a feedback circuit. So some of the output comes back to the input. So with our minds, we have a feedback circuit also where, we have input coming in, and based on that input, we can have a different output. So I would say, we basically, in some ways, I guess a good analogy is a computer or a Google driving car. For example, a self-driving car, you can say, go to point A to point B. Okay, so it's going to go. And if the road's blocked, it's going to make a calculation and say, okay, I will go around this way or go left or right. Step on the gas, put on the brake, whatever to avoid an accident, but there's feedback there and it's making decisions based on all these inputs. And we're doing the same exact thing. We're looking at all these inputs and making decisions. So as we share ideas, that's what all we're doing. I'm giving you feedback, you're giving me feedback, and we're just looking at this feedback and making decisions based on it.
I mean, even in your Google car, given a knowledge of the conditions, you'll know exactly what the car does. So, given the knowledge of the feedback and how my brain is wired, what actual choice do I have to make as to what's going on? Isn't it all just a reflection of the particular state my brain is in?
Well, the Google car, I mean, everything's going to change based on the inputs of what's happening, though. I mean, like, for example, one Google car can go through the road and then the tree falls down, and the next Google car has to wait and go around it or whatever. So, maybe conceptually, if you knew the future in every exact moment, you could calculate it. Probably so, because if every atom is under control, but there's no way we would have computational power to know every neuron at every second and everything and all the feedbacks and everything that's going to happen in the future. Basically, we don't know what tree is going to fall when, so you have to go through life to find out what's going to happen. But so can you maybe close in 15 seconds because we're out of time now?
Yeah, I guess I would just, it's still a open question in my mind. How, if the physical world is all there is, we have this capacity to transcend that in our thoughts and say we have decisions. But I've enjoyed it's been interesting and helpful to listen to your responses, and so it helps me understand your position better. So I appreciate that.
All right, and thanks for coming on the show. I really appreciate that too.
All right, thanks. Have a good evening, Bernie.
Okay.